Hey dolls, we're the Designer Twins. Welcome to our channel. So today we're going to be talking about our monthly favorites. So if you guys would like to know what the Designer Twins are like this month, please continue to watch this video. Make sure you like, subscribe, and follow. We're going to be talking about makeup. Our makeup, some of our Holy Grail products.
Some of our favorites this month. We got a lot of really good Holy Grails that we highly, highly recommend.
So let's
jump into it. What do you got?
Okay, so I'm going to talk about NYX first. And the first one I'm going to talk about is the NYX Away We Glow Liquid Highlighter. This shit is the bomb.
Can you guys see?
Oh, there you go.
The shade is called Daytime Halo. We have to swatch them. Because if you can see on my cheeks now,
ooh!
I am wearing it on my cheeks here. What you do is you dab some on your face, and then I like to blend it with my finger.
But look at this.
You guys, it's like the truth. And what I like to do when I'm wearing this liquid highlighter is I like to put,
I like to set mine with the Anastasia highlighter kit, the shade Summer. I go right on top of it just to set it because it is a liquid to make sure it doesn't come off. But that is literally what I am wearing
today. This highlighter is bomb. It's like a good highlighter primer base. Yeah. Like you apply this first and then whatever powder or pressed highlighter you want to put on over it,
it just makes it pop, beam, honey.
Like 10 beam. Times more.
Look at that.
10 times more.
Show them your angle. I mean, the product does not lie. And this was like $6 at Ulta.
Yeah, really good pricing.
NYX Away We Glow and the liquid highlighter in the color Daytime Halo.
And we'll link the link for this below as well.
Look at this. It is definitely one you want to get, people.
Yes, I agree. The next products I'm going to be talking about is also NYX. And this is their lip liners. One of the colors is golden bronze, and that's actually the color that I'm wearing on my lips. This is just lip liner fully filled in on my lips. And then the other color is Urban Cafe. I don't know if you guys can see it. Urban Cafe. But these lip liners are the shit.
Like, I'll just swatch them so that they can see.
Oh yes, let me swatch these, honey. So you guys can see.
Oh, that is pretty.
Okay, so this one right here is golden bronze, and this one is the Urban Cafe. The Urban Cafe, I literally wear under everything from nudes to pinks to reds, and it just makes my lips look fuller. And it also just shows my lip line more, because my bottom lip is a lot fuller than my top lip, as you can see. And then this one, this is my first time actually wearing this one, and I decided to buy it because I love the Urban Cafe so much. And yeah, it's on my lips and I love it. They're really good.
It's so cute. Since she just showed you guys some metallic stuff, I definitely need to show you these Smashbox lippies that I got. These are freaking amazing. These are Smashbox, and they're in the color Petal Metal and Crimson Chrome. Let me swatch these so you guys can see, because these, oh my god, my lips be looking fucking amazing.
Yeah, these are really good.
These are really, really good, and they last all day. It's like almost like using a matte lipstick. You know how a matte lipstick stays on all day? Like, these are like that, but they're metallic.
And they're really pigmented, too.
Really pigmented. So this one is Petal Metal, the lightest shade here. Petal Metal, and then of course this is the crimson chrome here. But I mean, they just look so metallic, so yummy and delicious on the lips. Like, I fucking love it. They just give your lips this beautiful pop, this glow. My lips just be looking so juicy.
Are you wearing that right now or no?
I am not wearing it right now. Today I am wearing MAC liquid lipstick just because I didn't want to have too much shine. But maybe I should swatch it for you guys. Maybe I should like put it on.
I think you should put it on top just to show them.
Cause I think we should. So
you're just giving off the red vibe. So why not apply it on top?
You see, it just gives.
Let me see. Ooh, it just made it like more metallic. Like
how so much more metallic.
Yeah, I love it. That's really cute, and I don't even like red lipstick.
So.
Ooh, fancy.
I mean, get into the kit.
Yes. Okay. The kid got the red lips though.
The kid got the red lips though.
Uh-huh. So next, I'm going to be talking about
glitter.
Can she? Excuse me. Glitter, guys. Glitter.
I love me some glitter.
She does. She do love glitter. Yes, I'm going to be talking about glitter. So our bestie, Tamarie. Hey, girl.
Hey, Mari.
She went to this beauty store in the Valley, and she came back. She came back to her house and we were all like chilling and stuff. And she was like, oh my God, y'all need to try these
JCat about these glitters.
And we're like, what? What are they? What are they? Because, you know, we've been wanting to get some glitters. So she's like, y'all have to try them. Like, they're really inexpensive. Y'all have to get some. So we finally went and got some.
We actually found them just at a regular beauty supply.
A regular beauty supply store.
Nothing fancy, just a regular beauty supply. I think they were, what, $2?
Yes, they were $2.
And these are the colors I got. So I got a lime green, a pink, and like an iridescent color one.
And I got the lime green as well. And then I also got a pink, and I got a bronzy gold one. And
they don't have any. It's best to get the NYX Glitter Glue.
Oh,
that
yes.
That stuff works amazing with any kind of glitter. But you just put that the NYX Glitter Glue on your eyes, and then it has some of that right
yes,
there.
Yes, that's what I was going to tell you guys on my NYX rant. The NYX Glitter Glue, it has an iridescent packaging around it. That's how you'll know like the difference from the glues. But this is really good. Like, I've tried it when I used the glitters, and yeah, it sticks and it doesn't move and it doesn't crease too much either. So I recommend this for sure.
For sure. Next, we're going to be talking about Holy Grail, honey.
Holy Grail.
Holy Grail. And that would be foundation.
Yes. Finally, right?
We both have oily skin and we've tried multiple different foundations from drugstore to high-end. But we finally found one that we both agree that is a must-have, you must-have, you must-have. And that would be the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation, honey.
Yes.
I am in the shade 5W1 Bronze.
And I am in the shade 4W1 Honey Bronze.
This foundation is absolutely amazing. Like, it gives you such flawless, full coverage finish. Mm-hmm. It lasts all day.
All day.
We're wearing it now, both of us. And look how flawless our makeup is. Like,
I mean, I kid you not, when the lights come on in a club,
we ain't hiding from the light, baby.
We ain't.
I highly recommend anyone who's looking for some foundation to definitely consider the Double Wear. If you're a newbie, maybe not. But if you're someone who's been wearing foundation for a while and you do not have this, you must get this.
You must.
Go to Macy's. Macy's will color match you. They will tell you your perfect color. They will also give you samples for you to test it out.
Yes.
It's amazing. We get ours from Sephora because we get points.
Yes.
But
gotta get the points.
Gotta get the points. You gotta get this. Like, it's flawless.
It's just life.
It's life.
And it's not as expensive as other foundations that we've bought before, you know, like this is good. It's a good price.
I think it's less than 40.
Yes.
But yeah, like
we'll put the link for this, okay? Macy's and Sephora, whichever one you want to shop at. Okay, so this is the Nubian by Juvia's eyeshadow palette. I hope I pronounced that correct. I don't know if you can see it. And pretty much like this palette is a really good palette. Like, I was kind of skeptical about trying it because I have so many eyeshadows and I'm like, why do I need to get another eyeshadow palette? But honestly, this is probably my favorite eyeshadow palette out of every palette that I have. And I travel with this palette the most. I don't have to bring any other extra eyeshadows with me. Here's the colors. As you can see on this one, I hit pan because it's probably the one I use the most as a base. But yeah, and her shadows are so pigmented. I've been trying to get my channel to try it.
I have so many eyeshadow palettes that I'd be like, okay, I'm not buying one unless I really need it. But this palette, I'm sleep. Like, I've been sleep. I've been sleep.
She's sleep.
I'm gonna get it, y'all.
Her prices are so good. Like, for all of these eyeshadows, I probably paid $20. And I could be wrong, but it's around that price range. Don't quote me, but I'll link it. Get it. Don't be sleep like her.
Yeah, it seems like it's a holy grail. Like, I definitely feel like I should get it.
Yeah, it really is.
I just have so many. And it's like, they all be having the same fucking color. So it's like,
she came and swept the eyeshadow palette game the fuck up. Okay? Okay. That's all I gotta say about that. The next two makeups I wanna talk about, and this is the last I'm gonna be talking about makeup because I can go on for days. The first one is this Makeup Forever Under Eye powder, setting powder, and it looks like this. So it's so funny because she put me on to this. She
said it did not work for me at all. Like, I'm so jealous that she's discussing like, this because she, I did not like it.
I know. She literally put me onto this and I was like, okay, I'm going to try it. I don't really, you know, care to change my under eye powder because I was already using one and it was really good. But she was like, no, you have to try it. You have to try it. So I'm like, okay, I'm going to try it. I love this stuff. Like, even with, because I kind of have like little pockets under my eyes, and I kid you not, like when I put my concealer on and I set it with this, it literally takes away the pockets under my eyes. Like, it's kind of crazy. And when she explained to me why I should get it, I'm like, I don't really think I need it. But this, I don't use nothing else but this under my eyes for Makeup Forever. Like,
it's like when I tried to use it, it was like it wasn't setting my concealer. I would put my concealer on, and when I took my beauty blender and tried to put the product on my beauty blender, it wasn't coming on my beauty blender. It came on there like kind of patchy.
Yeah.
And then even when I went over to like set it, when I would take pictures, I would have like a highlight, like a white flashback underneath my eye. Like, it just wasn't working.
Yeah, it's crazy. Like we said, all the products that we are mentioning, some of them will work for you and some of them won't, you know? So try all of these at your own risk. But I do like this. And it's actually called the Ultra HD powder. So yeah, try it. And I also apply this with my Beauty Blender Dapped. And I'll do it like kind of after I do my makeup, and I'll just put it on there and just set it. And I don't let it bake. You just set it and it's good to go. I really do like this one. And my last product I'm going to be talking about is the Cover FX blotting powder. So basically I use this powder to set my foundation.
I use that too.
And it looks like this. And I am in the color medium. And this, we used to use the loose powder from Cover FX to set our foundation. And I like that one too.
The loose gets everywhere.
Yeah, the loose powders are messy.
Gets everywhere. They're so fucking messy.
Yeah, they really are. So when we went to Sephora, Anna had asked, you know, the helper or the salesperson to, you know, do they have one that is pressed? And I kid you not, ever since she asked if they have a pressed one, I'm like, I'll never go back to the loose powder one because this is really good. You like yours, right?
Yeah, I like mine.
Yeah, like I just feel like it sets the makeup good and it's not cakey.
Yeah, no.
It's really light.
Very light powder that you go over your foundation just to set your foundation. Because whenever you're using a liquid, you definitely want to set it with a powder. And you don't want it to look heavy or cakey.
No.
And this powder, you just get your little powder brush and you just put some on there and just dab it all over your face. What I like to do is when my makeup is completely done, I'll get my big brush again, put some more on there, and just kind of go a circular motion all over my face.
Yeah.
And that kind of buffs everything together and kind of morph everything together in a bit for a bit. But I do that once everything is on.
Yes.
I'll go over it again. But I really like it.
Yeah, it's really good. And it's not that expensive either. And a long way. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, I recommend this product too.
Next up, I want to talk about something that a lot of people are a little bit shy about, and that is your period. We all get one every month, you know, every that time of the month come, and it is like hell week. Okay, I don't know about y'all, but for me, it is not fun, you know? I started looking into other alternatives besides tampons because I really did not like the way it felt going in and out of me. You know,
I fucking hate tampons.
Some days it just made my uterus feel very dry and uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. So we were at a pop-up shop event and there was a booth there from a company that's called Flex. They are called Flex, and what it is a menstrual cup. I'm sorry, it's a menstrual cup. Most menstrual cups you can clean and reuse them, but there's a lot of steps that you need to do to make sure that they're clean and sanitary. With this one, it is disposable. So let me just show you guys what it looks like. It comes in this little black packaging, like so. Inside of the box comes with 10. I clearly have used them. The box comes with 10. And it looks like this. So what you do is when you open them, it looks like a big ass condom. This is what it looks like. And you know that this is the inside cup because it looks like that. So the way that it works is you sit on your toilet, you relax, you pinch the cup like so, to whereas it's almost the shape of a tampon like this. And when you sit down, you literally will slide it into your uterus. And once you push it all the way in at the tip, you want to push your finger in there a little bit because you then want to push the bottom so the cup kind of angles like this. So as you're entering it into the vagina, right, you then want to push the bottom so the cup levels. So then the blood falls into the cup. And you'll feel it. Like once you literally, as you're gliding it into the uterus, once you get the tip in there, like you'll feel it as you pushing it in there. And you'll feel when it's locked in and secure. And once you stand up, it feels like you're wearing nothing. The great thing about this thing, you can have it in for 12 hours. You can still have sex while you have it in. And it's super easy to put in, pull out. While pulling it out, I didn't experience any blood overflowing or getting messy. It was very clean. Everything stayed in a cup. And then I just threw it away. So if you're a girl who are tired of using tampons and who may use pads, I definitely highly would recommend looking into Flex. I will put the link below so you guys can check them out. I don't think I'll ever go back to using tampons. Like, they're just fucking uncomfortable, and I hate it. I highly recommend it if you want an alternative while you're on your cycle. It feels like you're wearing nothing. Like, you're wearing nothing. I just put a little liner to protect my underwear just in case. But for the 7 days that I used it, I had no problems whatsoever. So I would definitely highly, highly recommend it.
She recommends it, y'all.
Right out. Next, we're going to talk about fashion. We have some fun little goodies that we got this month. So first up, we're going to talk about some shoes. We both got a new pair of shoes this month. I got these super fun and cute heels. One of our friends has a shoe line called 12 AM. And these are some of her shoes. It is a pink, kind of more like a purplish pink.
Really cute.
It laces around the leg and it has these little tassels at the end. I have not worn these yet. I can't wait though. They're super, super cute.
Yeah, they're cute. I can't wait to see what look you put together with those. The shoes I want to talk about is Vans, the low top black Vans. I mean, Avi, these are classic Vans. Everyone are in them right now. And it literally reminds me of back in the Bay, like in high school, like the Wolfpack, their song Vans. No, but it for real takes me back to high school. And I just needed to get a pair because they go with everything. And yeah, they make me look super like hip, like a little hipster, like I'm from Berkeley or something. Shout out to the Bay.
Don't ask the gal or shop there, but you know, they went through their big situation where they filed for bankruptcy. Now their entire website is always 50% off. The quality of the site is not as great as it was before the bankruptcy. Man. But if you really sit there and go through all of the pages, you can find some good shit. Because I found some good shit.
Like, we used to be on Nasty Girl every day.
Every day.
Like, every day.
Holy Grail. So this is a really cute iridescent metallic snake skin clutch that I recently purchased from Nasty Gal. It is a box clutch, and it's just like this.
You love these purses. You have like 20 of them.
I do. It has this little gold chain that is removable, and I mean, it's just cute, right? It'll definitely go cute with the shoes.
I agree.
Hello! It's a party.
It's a look.
It's a moment, honey. Mm-hmm. I also from Nasty Gal, I got just let it have a moment.
Okay, this jacket.
Super lit fucking unicorn motorcycle leather jacket. 50% off. 50% off. This is from Nasty Gal.
This it literally reminds me of a party. Like,
it reminds me of a party. Like, I just want to put this jacket on and dance. Like, all over the world. I just want to shake my arms.
Yes.
Get it. It's fucking lit. Like, it has these beautiful rainbow tassels on the back. It's gorge.
That is fucking cute. I wouldn't even expect for that to be on there.
And those are my fashion pieces that I got this month. What you got?
This necklace I actually got from the Melrose flea market, and the brand is Vita Kush. If you look them up on Instagram, she has a lot of cool stuff, and I was surprised to see her at the flea market because I was just walking and I was like, oh my gosh, she has a booth there, and I got this necklace from here, and it reminds me of Kanye collection that he did of his necklaces, and I was like, I need to get something that looks like it. And then when I saw this on her little rack, I was like, girl, ring me up. Like, I love it. I get so many compliments on it. And it's like two chains. Like, it's a choker and then a long chain after it. So
cute.
It's kind of like I'm layering. And I love the gold chain layer look. It's so popular right now. And I'm just so into it. I love my gold chains. Yep. The perfume that I want to talk about today that's been my favorite right now is Bond Number 9. And the scent is Andy Warhol. And it looks like this. I don't know if you guys can see. But this, first off, Bond Number 9 is really expensive, but it lasts all day. Like, I get so many compliments when I wear Bond, and people be like, oh my God, what are you wearing? But yeah, this has been my favorite this month. I've been wearing it like every day, and I love it. And their bottles are always so cool. It always has really cool artwork on them. And yeah, I love it. It smells so good.
I want to just kind of talk about our favorite music, because there is some really, 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 really good music out right now. And there's
songs.
A couple songs that I am obsessed with. First, y'all know Meek Mill, Wins and Losses came out this month. That is Meek's my favorite rapper of all time.
We love Meek. Period. Okay?
Meek, we fucks with you. You a real nigga. We fucks with Meek. Meek woke a fucking sleeping giant inside
Philly
of me.
What's good?
So Wins and Losses is a great album. I highly recommend you download it and listen to it. If anybody think Meek took an L, listen to this album, and he definitely gonna change your mind by the time you finish it.
Crazy, because it just came out. I think it actually came out at midnight. It just came out. But that new Nicki and Future song. And we love Nicki. We love Nicki.
Should we play that?
Yeah, this is a banger.
Fuck them hoes.
Yeah, I like that song.
We hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please make sure you like, subscribe, and follow our channel. Be on the lookout for any new videos we have coming.
And let us know what you guys want to see from us. Like, yeah,
what you want us to do. What y'all want to see. What you want us to do. We got some fun shit.
We do.
That we're going to be doing. But if you guys want anything specific you want to know about, have any questions, please feel free to ask.
Yes. We always link our social media. So even if, you know, you guys don't think we see your comments on here, we'll see them. But if you also want to hit us up on social media, do that as well.
All the information will be below, around. You'll find it.
Just let us know what you
look at our other videos. Also, we have some fun videos. Watch our birthday vlog, because our birthday vlog was lit as fuck.
That's all I gotta say is,
it was a party.
It was lit.
Yeah, it was lit as fuck.
Yes. But we'll see you guys in our next video.
Thanks for watching.
Mwah.